First of all, Salim Bayo is working in 2018 at the Art Rotterdam Fair, and I was struck by it because it's so fascinating because he works in different media, tried really big installations, doing things with the language, audio, and also wearables. So actually you can say he's a craftsman, and actually you cannot frame him, and that's also what I love about his work. And that's because he's using so many different materials, but also crossing over in different cultures, different symbols, different time periods. It's also the title of the exhibition, Moving Archive. An archive, normally it's fixed. We have an archive here in our museum. His archive is in his mind, but also in his phone, and also printed in ceramic or in epoxy. I've never seen someone so happy with all these old pieces. He was running around in our storage yesterday, and he was just scanning what fits into my archive exhibition that I see here, really intuitively. And that's also how he works. He collects dirt, sand, everything around him, and he makes it into something. He creates his own world in the show.
So the idea was just to scout around and see what I found. Clear sand, soil, dirt, gravel. It's like a type of ADHD.
Okay.
But with materials. Just being curious, most of all. Just try to give a chance for something unpredictable to happen. So that's why I try to kind of leave some parts a bit loose. Like that one there, it's a specific screenshot that I took from my phone. Some of them are abstract, but the whole thing is trying to make a landscape somehow. It's an image of a sort of laying figure becoming dirt and start to become fused with the surroundings.
Is this the Saad Ali figure? I thought it was really interesting to see that that character is kind of this one of the few that really recurs across every format or every medium. And I wondered a bit about this Saad Ali figure, like what does it allow? You know, it seems like it really gives you this way to sort of observe spaces or comment on spaces.
Yeah. Flip it around. So for example, you can come up with a word and then as you use it, it starts making more sense. There's this character, I don't really know much about it. It just came out as an anecdote. As it crawls through mediums and places, maybe it will
It's defining itself as it.
Yeah. Wow. Something like that. And then hopefully one day it will become something else. We had this idea that popped up, which is the title of the show, Moving Archive. So that's this paradox we're trying to tackle, like how things are fixed and how you can modify them or appropriate them or destroy them. Also not knowing, for example, we went upstairs to the archive and I had a look and I just picked objects that are unknown, they have no information about. For example, I just found a broom. It was there.
Sure.
And when you think and it's a place like this, it will be taken care of for the next 100 years or something. So it just also questions the value of things.
Yeah.
So the value is just something that is put on top, you know, it's not intrinsic. Also trying to provoke this point where it changes meaning or it gains a new meaning. That's what I'm trying to push. So you have these things and see how far you can take them until they reveal themselves or completely just vanish and you realize you've been obsessing with it for no reason. This would be a sort of Airbnb situation. The host wants to get out. The guest has money.
Yeah.
Who wants to get out, who wants to settle. But this one, you can move this cross. So in this case, you can declare whether you're a lion or a human, or very little human and very little lion. Lion like an abstract thing.
Mm-hmm.
This slideshow, I call it Cloud Play, and it's literally just scrolling through my cloud, all the pictures I've been taking, and I'm making a sequence. The idea is that finding links, and they are in my head, but then when these links are just, I'm inviting you to do it, you come up with something completely different. And they are all projected on a buttermilk. It's a way to suggest something that is alive, something that can rot or cannot or can become cheese. That's why I like digital tools, because you can destroy and add without big consequences. They are called the sketching tools. And yeah, I mean, all this is a bit like trying to mimic. I would like to live in moving places. And when you realize that when you move from A to B, how your value changes and the accent you have, the language you use, the way you behave. It's a constant negotiation with your surroundings. Like we tend to think in a wrong way, starting with conclusions. But for example, you say, oh, a Zoom meeting is so impersonal, blah, blah, blah. But it can become more personal Mm-hmm. It has this potential. It's yeah. just about how. For example, when I want to be very intimate with someone on distance, I prefer just voice. So more information, more technology doesn't mean more proximity. I don't like to think in like these categories, like online, offline. Online, but how? Offline, but how, you know?
Right.